no.
Okay.
Yes and no. Yes, in the sense that you create a sense of continuity to this concept called the past,
mm-hmm.
and therefore you can use it in a variety of ways if you wish to help you move forward. That's viable. At the same time, it doesn't really exist. You have been taught to think that it does because of your space-time perspective and this idea called continuity that makes you think there is an actual linear connection between the past and the present when there really isn't. You are creating your past from the present, not the other way around. So when you become a new person, every moment that you change anything about yourself, you're a new person. And that means you actually, at that moment, have a new past. The past you had to have had to make sense in space and time of how you became the person you now are. So the idea is that you're not actually creating things or holding on to things from the past, in a sense, technically speaking. But what you're doing every moment that you redefine yourself is you are including that concept over and over and over again that something came from your childhood.
Mm.
But it didn't necessarily come from your childhood anymore because you have been a new person and you're creating a new past that didn't necessarily have the experience you're talking about.
Okay.
So you don't have to keep connecting to it. Now, for some people on your planet, that's a lot to wrap their minds around, and they may not be able to do it that way. So there are other techniques, many other permission slips you can use, even using the idea that there is something that happened in childhood that is still causing trauma. Fine. You can go that route if you want, and there are many techniques to help you through it. But I'm just simply telling you mechanically what's actually happening is there's no such thing.